For a long time now, pretty much everyone in the state of California, if you're into guns, has known that the Santa Clara County Sheriff's Department has had some sort of bribery or pay-to-play scheme when it comes to issuing a CCW permit. Now, in the state of California, issuing a CCW permit is determined by the sheriff. The sheriff has discretion on what's considered good cause for carry, and it appears as if people that have donated heavily to Sheriff Lori Smith's campaign fund and re-election funds have had a massively more likely outcome of them actually getting their CCW. It's basically impossible for the person that doesn't have $5,000 to $40,000 apparently, or high status in the community, to throw a lot of money or a lot of goods, a lot of services to the sheriff's department and to specifically Lori Smith for them to actually get it. If they don't do those things, you're basically not going to get it. Today we're talking about some indictments that happened and some charges for the bribery when it comes to CCW licenses. Before we do that, I want to say thank you to the sponsor of this channel, Franklin Armory. I was actually with them last weekend doing some filming. I shot some full autos, I shot some binary triggers, I shot their Title I. We saw some cool stuff. I'm very excited about the future with the company. Thank you for having me out. Check out their CA7, CA11, or CA12 pistols. They're great people supporting us in California. I'm going to be talking about the Title I and some of the other stuff when it comes to them in a later video, but I just wanted to cover this news topic first. Also, I'm giving away a PSA complete firearm kit, a complete rifle kit. I got it in today. I want to do some little inspections, make sure it's all good to go. I'm going to throw in a couple little extra goodies maybe, and I'm going to be actually doing the giveaway for that tomorrow. All you have to do to be entered is be a member of the Subscribe Star. There's a $2 tier. Obviously, if you don't have the money or if you don't want it, do not enter, do not feel obligated, but there's some cool rewards and I would greatly appreciate the support. So I have actually two links that are going to be down in the description. This is going to be one from the Mercury News, which is a local news station. And then I'm also just going to be today reading from the Office of the District Attorney, their press release. So it's the County Undersheriff, Sheriff Captain, Local Businessman, and Apple Chief Security Officer charged with bribery for CCW licenses. This was released actually today, which is a very new information. I'm going to recommend that you first read from this source first because it's just less ads, more straight information. A grand jury has issued two indictments charging the Santa Clara County Sheriff's Santa Clara County Undersheriff, a previously indicted sheriff's captain, a local business owner, and the head of global security for Apple with bribery. So yeah, you know the company that took away the gun emoji on their iPhones? Yeah, it turns out the head of security for them wants a CCW and was involved in some bribery schemes. So thank you, Apple. Very cool. Undersheriff Rick Sung, 48, and Captain James Jensen, 43, are accused of requesting bribes for CCW licenses, while insurance broker Harpreet Chadha and Apple's chief security officer Thomas Moyer are accused of offering bribes to get them. They're going to be arraigned on the 11th this year in San Jose. If convicted, they could receive prison time. I honestly highly doubt that they're going to get prison time because I doubt the effectiveness of the criminal justice system for those that are in power and those that are wealthy. DA Jeff Rosen said, Undersheriff Sung and Captain Jensen treated CCW licenses as commodities and found willing buyers. Bribe seekers should be reported to the district attorney's office, not rewarded with compliance. Now, in the case of four CCW licenses withheld from Apple employees, Undersheriff Sung and Captain Jensen managed to extract from Thomas Hoyer a promise that made that Apple would donate iPads to the sheriff's office. The promise donation of 200 iPads worth close to $70,000 was scuttled at the 11th hour just after August 2nd, 2019, when Sung and Moyer learned of the search warrant that the district attorney office executed at the sheriff's office, seizing all of its CCW license records. So the only reason that Santa Clara County Sheriff's Department did not receive 200 iPads from Thomas Moyer and Apple was because on August 2nd, the two people involved, and most likely Lori, but we can't say that, that's just allegedly she knew, found out that they were going to actually be served a warrant and that this was going to be the kibosh was going to be thrown down on it, which is honestly just insane. In the case of the CCW license withheld from Harpreet Chadha, Sung managed to extract from Chadha a promise of $6,000 worth of luxury box seat tickets to a San Jose Sharks hockey game at the SAP Center on Valentine's Day of 2019. Sheriff Lori Smith's family members and some of her biggest political supporters held a small celebration of her re-election as sheriff in this suite. Now, a lot of you are probably asking, what about Lori Smith? What about the actual sheriff? When is she going to be brought in? We saw that she's involved in some way with these people that have been in the cahoots for the CCW bribery scheme, but she hasn't been brought in yet, and she hasn't been forced to testify on this yet, so I'm very interested about when that's going to happen. Now, some information I got from someone who they are going to remain anonymous, and I'm going to do my best to not give away any information about who they are. They said they met the sheriff a few times in a meeting, and that they met the undersheriff many times. I can tell you that the undersheriff Sung is such an ass kisser. My bet is that he will spill the beans on the sheriff since he is that type of person who will not let himself take all the blame. He will make a deal, in my opinion. Also, it is well known by his rank and file that to get promoted, you must endorse her and help her get reelected. This is per several people who have spoke to me from, I'm not going to say where they work, in the sheriff's office, not just random street cops or normal citizens. Then he goes on to say that the former VP of the union has gone on to criticize her many times in the media. Also, the board of supervisors here, or at least three or more of them, are not a fan of the sheriff. The county executive, Jeff Smith, does not like her either. This is pretty interesting. Knowing from someone that I do trust, I can't give you their information. You just got to kind of take this with a grain of salt. This is all speculation. But it's interesting to see that someone is saying that many people involved higher up don't like Lori Smith as well. I mean, fuck Lori Smith. All the homies hate Lori Smith. It's really cool to see that we have some process actually going forward. This is something that if you look on CalGuns threads going back to like the early 2000s, you would see people saying basically the same thing, that Santa Clara County, you're not going to get a CCW. And then within the last like 5 or 6 years, you see a lot more threads of people saying that it's basically a pay to play scheme. Basically everyone knew. And if they asked someone that worked for the sheriff's department, they said, hey, how do you think I can get a CCW? Or do you think you can help me get a CCW? They would basically just laugh and say, yeah, unless you're donating to the sheriff's campaign, which in one case we saw someone donated $40,000 for about 12 CCW permits for their department. Pretty interesting, right? We see this person, Harpreet Chadha, donating about $6,000 worth of luxury box seat tickets to the San Jose Sharks game. We then see about $70,000 worth of iPads that were going to be donated, I guess, or pay to play, I guess, go into the bribery scheme. So it's interesting to see all these people are actually getting caught. I don't blame the people that are taking advantage of it. I don't blame the people that are paying money. I mean, they're kind of shitty people if they're knowingly taking advantage of it and not spilling the beans on it. But, you know, at the end of the day, if you have the money, flex it. You know, I think you're a piece of shit, but I see why you would want it, because everybody wants to protect themselves. And currently, people in Santa Clara County, specifically people that are of lower income or lower status in the community, the people that, you know, are probably more likely to be attacked on a daily basis, those are the people that are getting hurt by this. The people that can't legally carry to protect themselves have to make a choice. Do they risk getting killed on the street because they are unable to protect themselves? Or do they risk getting caught having the means to protect themselves illegally? Honestly, this is all just a really nasty topic. I don't like talking about it, but I love seeing justice being served to these people. If you have any comments, any questions, anything that you want to add, drop that comment down below. If you have anything that you want to tell me in private, feel free to drop me an email down below. You guys know the drill. Have fun, be safe, stay dangerous. Peace.